At the Ames Laboratory, we try to discover, design, make new materials. I'm Paul Canfield, and I'm a research physicist at Ames Laboratory, as well as a professor at Iowa State University. And I'm going to take you through the steps involved in trying to make a new material. You can take crucibles, and you can put elements in them, and then put them in silica tubes. And once you have everything packed, you can seal the tube with a blowtorch so as to create a growth ampule. You can neck it, and you can seal it off. At this point, it's a self-contained environment that you can have your crystal growth take place in. You take this ampule, put it in a larger crucible, and then ultimately put it into a furnace that will provide the temperature environment needed for the growth process. This is similar to growing sugar crystals out of water. You heat the water up until the sugar dissolves and cool it down. We just heat to higher temperatures, here 1125. Now, at this point, we reach into a red-hot furnace after having grown the crystals and separate the crystals from the remaining liquid. It's like taking sugar crystals out of the water before it freezes. Okay? We use a centrifuge to provide an enhanced gravitational environment. Once the samples are cooled, we can actually open them. So we remove the crucibles. We can look in the growth crucible, sort of in the Stonehenge moment. But then we break it open and see what we find. And what we can see is sort of like opening a Christmas present. You never know if it's socks or the desired pony or whatever. Now, in this case, it's actually beautiful. These are crystals of lutetium germanium II, a material that we think might have exotic electronic properties.
Oh yeah! Oh!
These are the first single crystals we've been able to grow of them. What we'll do is we'll remove the crystals, shape them into the size needed for electrical measurements, magnetic measurements, thermal measurements, and interview the material. Ask it, are you interested? And based on those results, decide what to grow next.